Welcome to the first Linkage tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be creating a simple four-bar mechanism and exploring some other features of the Linkage program. Move the mouse cursor to the middle of the window and click the right button to display the pop-up element gallery. Pick the link that has two connectors, one of which is an input anchor. The link is added to the mechanism and is selected. The yellow highlight is only shown on newly added elements. Left-click in an empty part of the window to unselect the link. You can then use the left mouse button to drag the connector and the link around the window. Just press and hold the left mouse button on a connector or link to drag it. Release the button to stop dragging the element. To select more than one connector, click on one connector, then hold the Shift or Control key down while selecting other connectors. When the black boxes appear around selected elements, you can grab the boxes and change the size and shape of the selection. Now right-click somewhere to the right of the first link and add an anchor. An anchor is a connector that connects to the ground. The ground is like the frame of a truck or the floor of a factory. Anchors never move and at least one is required. For our mechanism, two anchors are needed. In fact, a four-bar mechanism is only drawn with three bars because the ground is the fourth bar. Right-click above the new anchor and add a connector. This new connector is not an anchor. Select both the new connector and the lone anchor we added a few moments ago. Now click on the connect button in the toolbar to create a link between the two connectors. A link must always have at least two connectors. A link with two ordinary connectors can be added, just like we added the first link of the tutorial. Right-click to show the element gallery and pick the simple two-connector link. To make a connection between two links, the links must share a connector. Moving two connectors on top of each other, even if they are in the exact same spot, does not connect two links. The connectors must both be selected and then joined. Select the connectors, then click on the Join button in the toolbar. The two connectors become a single connector that connects the two links. Notice how the two links are stretched and moved when the connector is moved. The mechanism is now functional. All of the parts connect together and the movement is well defined. Press the play button in the toolbar to start a simulation. The simulation runs in real time in the same window where the mechanism is designed. The stop button stops the simulation. The visual appearance of a link can be altered by selecting it and showing the properties box. The line width of this link will be changed and one of the other links will be made solid. A solid link is drawn as if it has a width and rounded ends. The line width and solid look of a link are not draw the same number of inches or millimeters for a link, they are draw the same size on the screen to make visualizing and designing the mechanism easier. The name of a connector or a link can be changed if needed. But if no name is given, the assigned number letter of a connector or number of a link is shown. Don't forget to save your work now and then. The main menu has the Open, Save, Print, Export, and other typical menu items. Look for more tutorials on this video channel. Thanks for watching.